Alrighty, boys. Gonna go hit the gym, chest of buys. Sat down at work. Seems like hella smoky out. Filming with my phone today, mainly because the camera I got. I mean, it's a good camera, don't get me wrong, but you know, you got the SD card that gets filled up. You got the battery that runs out. Once you run them back and forth to the locker room to grab that shit. And, you know, one of the main things you want to make sure, like, you're not doing, especially when you're filming, is sacrificing the quality of your workout just to film a YouTube video. You know, YouTube secondary, getting gains primary. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, my work is, like, literally across the street from the gym, so I'll film myself drive over there, talk to you guys, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, I filmed a video last Friday, didn't like it too much, bad lift, and I'm just trying to get a good schedule going. So what I've decided on doing is I'm gonna hit chest and buys chest and buys at this gym in Cabo I'm going to right now. Shoulders and arms, I'm gonna hit at my workplace gym. Legs, I'm gonna hit my workplace gym, and back and triceps, I'm gonna hit at home. That's really it. I just had to figure it out, like, get a consistent schedule going so I knew where I was gonna train. But I was getting, like, what lifts I was gonna hit and whatnot. So I hope you got all that figured out. We're good to go. Ideally, I don't wanna be filming this from my phone, like my main phone, because of storage and whatnot. But it's gonna be gonna have to work for now. It's for today. I'd straight up just like to get a new phone, have one phone straight up for filming, and then just keep this phone for, like, contacts and whatnot. Anyway, that was the drive to the gym. So, yeah, we're going to go in there. It's like 6 o'clock, so it's going to be busy. We're going to try to film, try to not piss people off. Just be nice. Catch you guys in there. Yeah. That felt smooth. Even on a dumbbell bench. I'm gonna try and get 45 for 12. Oh, Rudy, you're a big guy. Why are you using 45s? Well, I control my eccentric. So I'm talking, like, you know, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, you know what I'm saying? Deep stretch, pause at the bottom, push back out. You know, it's hard to do a bunch of weight when your technique is really, really good. So we'll see what I mean here.
So again, slow eccentric, stretch at the bottom. extend your chest out, drive the weight in.
The philosophy behind that whole thing is, you know, you want to use as light as weight as possible and make it hard through having, you know, good form, you know, watching your tempo. So you don't want to use, you know, I could throw around 85 pounds for like fast reps, 8 reps maybe. But the stimulus and the fatigue just wouldn't be there. So if I'm doing 45s for a deep stretch, going slow down, that's where the real growth is, you know what I'm saying? Gonna run the same thing now, just incline. Notice I'm not fully locking out. No, I understand if you're like a powerlifter and for competition standards you want to lock out, but like in the gym training, the gains you make from here to here, there's nothing being done muscularly, so there's no point, there's no gains being made there. The gains you made at the bottom of the movement, you stretch. You can skip walking out if you'd like. I like you for bench, because I feel like it just, my shoulder, it's in a weird position when I'm walking out, especially for dumbbells. Like, because my arch, I'm walking out like this. So it's just kind of weird. Just remember, like, the bottom of the movement,
That's where the growth is. The contraction at the top, the bottom, the deep stretch, is where you can get all that good quality stimulus.
I'm also wearing a pump cover in the middle of summer, 80 degrees outside, because the AC is crunk in here. So, gotta protect the pump, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so like right here, AC's right on me. Didn't have the pump cover on, pump would be gone right now, literally. So, anyway, chest press. Spot to put my phone, so deal with it, I guess, you know what I'm saying? Whoever used the tech deck last was an absolute menace, bro. Who hurt you, bro? You okay? You good, bro?
That's the tripod. That's right. Something about tech deck, right? Can I do tech deck? I hit peg deck low. The walk's going all right. I'm gonna start that job. By no means is it a hard job. I'm literally just a personal trainer for like a physical therapy place. Super fun, actually. I get to train like a bunch of old people, which is definitely nothing wrong with that. But, you know, it's full time, 40 hours a week. And just waking up at 6:30, you heard like waking up at noon. The amount of calories you burn, just doing that, is actually kind of shocking, I felt like. So like, I am bulking, but last year was kind of just a horrible week for lifting in general. All my lifts were down like 20 pounds. I got a little bit leaner. I was like, what's going on? Well, getting up at 6:30, you know, doing stuff for 8 hours a day, drinking caffeine, your heart rate's up like all day. So you just burn more calories. So I guess like the moral of that story, it's just like,
you know, calories in, calories out, I guess. So don't be shocked. If your activity level goes up and you start like losing weight, you become a little bit weaker. That's a normal thing. I'm bringing it up because like I know school's starting back up for a lot of you guys. So it's like sports, football, you know. If you're pushing it hard in the weight room,
And, you know, you're like, oh, I'm getting weaker. Or like, oh, you know, I'm kind of looking smaller. I'm looking leaner. You're losing weight. You don't feel as strong. You don't feel as good. But you just started a sport when you practice 2 hours a day out in the heat. Burning, you're probably burning an extra 500 to 600 calories a day, easy, during a football practice. You probably have to make up for that through eating some more, you know? Just some food for thought.
Now we're just gonna hit biceps real quick. This isn't my arm day, this is like chest and biceps. So I just hit biceps super quick. You know, it's like I hit biceps twice a week, but this is my like lighter bicep day. I have a heavier bicep day on arm day, so I'm just gonna hit them real quick.
So for these, the trick is, you know, really get that stretch in the bottom. Kibble rows, elbows in, like this. Pick these out as you come up. Not too much tension here, but as you really slowly go down, the bottom is a good stretch.
Everything's more beautiful because we're
first movement, one movement in front of you, like out like this, the one behind you. This might be like gym bro science, but I'll be filming an outro tomorrow. My phone is getting low on storage, and I'll probably cut out in a second.
How are you guys? Well, hope you guys enjoyed that video. Next video will probably be a leg day at my work gym. I've been hitting legs hard there. That stuff's fun. Gonna get back to editing soon. You see it's smoky. I'm running the sprinklers on top of the house right now, you know. I want the house to burn down. That'd be kind of tragic. Yeah. That's really it, man. Just gotta keep on keeping on, I guess. Oh, look at that. The sun. It's like red, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, peace.